Hi everyone, today I'm going to review a power supply tool. Technically saying, it is the DC diagnosis meter. The product is from the QianLi, this one. By the way, I don't get sponsor from this, so I can say whatever I want. You know, kind of like every QianLi product, they do have a nice box, a good backing, they pack it really well. It feels so premium, so then they can sell you really expensive. Okay, I already have installed this thing, but first I'm going to explain. This little power supply here, he got digital and the analog together, okay? Why do I bought it? It's not because my old power supply doesn't have the digital or about the reading. It is because I need these things on the top. You will see there's a little cut in here. See, this little cut is to install on the top, so then your cable output, it can act like the battery. As you can see, that little cut is not come together, okay? You need to buy this expansion card separately. Okay, let's say this one. It is support from iPhone 6 to 10s Max. And this one is iPhone 11 to 12 Pro Max. And you will see I have another little box here. Actually, it is still the same, from 11 to 12 Pro Max. So why I bought two of them? It is because the box itself is say, one cable come with three connector, okay, three output. So look at the rear thing here. This cable output, I already have solder. You have to solder yourself, okay? It is iPhone 12 and iPhone 11. And there's another one, it's empty, okay? Because I don't have the connector, they only give me two. Strange. So then I think maybe when I was removing the box, I accidentally dropped something, you know, I lost it. So then I bought another set, okay? Another set of 11 to 12 Pro Max. So let's open it. This one is completely new, open from the box. You take it out, okay? The exactly same cable, three output. Supposed to have three connector, okay? 11 and 12 and 12 Pro Max. Because 11, they're all using the same type of the connector. But the 12, they're not. Because iPhone 12 Pro Max is not same with the other iPhone 12 series. iPhone 12 series, they're using two type, okay? Only 12 Pro Max, they are not the same. So inside, I already have checked, okay? This one is never opened before. Can you see that? I only have two connector, but I have three cover, okay? So I already have checked. They don't give me the 12 Pro Max. It means that time when I bought it, nothing is missing, okay? Maybe somehow the whole product line, they forgot to give another connector. In case you don't know what I'm talking about, the iPhone 12 Pro Max, why it's different, right? It seems like the same thing. First, let me show you iPhone 12 Pro, or either 12 mini, whatever. So look at the battery connector here. Okay, you see the gray is the ground. Okay, the ground is on outside of the board. Okay, this is 12 Pro. Let's look at one more, 12 mini. Look at the battery connector here. Okay, ground on outside of the board. Okay, the positive on inside. So let's look at the 12 Pro Max. Okay, see, the ground is inside the board. Okay, the positive is on outside, facing outside. So if you plug in like this way, for sure, it will short. This is why I thought I lost it. Okay, I didn't expect they didn't give it. And also, I don't understand why we have to solder ourselves. Don't worry, after you bought it, there's an instruction. You can just scan the barcode and you will know what to do, okay? So this little cut here, it got some chip, a little circuit that can boot up the iPhone so you can enter the iOS to test the other function. It is because the normal cable like this one is a direct wire and there's nothing in between, right? No controller, no circuit. So let's get back to this little meter in here. Not only it has the analog and digital together, the first time I look at it, I didn't notice the dot behind is only one digit. If let's say we want the digital power supply, I prefer behind the dot it has two digit, because when I read something between 29 ma or 21 ma, there's still a big difference. if you say 0.2, I can't see behind is 9 or 1. You know. When I repair something that is very small response current, okay, it still can tell the difference, especially between the CPU not working or the CPU clock fail. However, he got a button in here, he can fine-tune the analog meter reading. The maximum of the analog reading is 2000 mA. This little thing is not a power supply. You still need a power supply to power it, okay? You don't see any button or any knob to turn on the voltage. It is because, you see behind this cable, this little thing here, you still need to power up from a power supply with these two cables. Also, you need another USB port. He got a Type-C connection here. This one is not supplying the main power. He just supply the reading in here. So, you need both. If you unplug this, you can't read anything. Even you raise up the power supply, nothing. So I'm going to plug it back. Now I'm going to show you how to control from the power supply. Here, this is my power supply. So if you raise the volt from here, see, if I put 0.6, it say I have a 0.62. Okay, continue to raise it. So 5.0. So when I reach 5.0, you see the little light here is blinking like this way. If you set below it, let's say 3.8 like this, the green line is stable, okay? These little things here, 30 volt and 2A. Now I'm going to use this to power up the iPhone 11. Okay, this iPhone 11 is fully working, no problem at all. So as you can see, I already disconnect the battery like this way and then plug in the cable. So then I'm going to inject about 3.8 like this, okay? Right now I'm going to press the power button. Okay, you can see it goes to 80 and then 110 like that and drop down again. So the analog reading is like that little only. I can say I haven't get used to it yet. Okay, I still prefer my old analog meter reading. So let's hold the power button and boot it up. Okay, I already boot into the iOS. As we can see, I don't notice there's a battery message. Okay? Usually there will be a battery message saying your battery is not genuine. So let's go to setting and drag down to the general about here. It only say the display is a genuine part. It didn't say anything about the battery. Strange. Okay. Maybe that expansion card is doing a good job. Okay. He can trick the phone. It has the original battery. Put the phone in the standby. The current should drop a lot. Okay. It is hovering about 100 mA and then lower and lower. So then we can know, is it drain more comparing to the other phone? That's not the point of the video. Okay, the point is I want to read the battery. Okay, plug in the cable and read from the PC. So after you plug in the cable, of course the current will drop all the way down because now it's using the USB current. So let's look at this iPhone 11. Okay, we can see the battery life is 100%. We click the details. Wow, 0 times charge. Okay, this is the information he gave it. So let's click this report. Somehow the battery serial number is NA, but it is still not giving the battery message. So after a few minutes, the phone is very stable. It doesn't even restart at all. So I can literally say we can power on like this way in a whole day, okay? Unless your phone has another problem. So if you are buying this for this purpose, it is very suitable. But if you're buying this for just a smaller power supply, then you're wrong because it still needs another power supply to power it up. At first, when I was buying it, I was hoping I can have a smaller power supply, everything just under single camera. So then I don't need another camera facing the power supply and the other tools. So it has a conflict with my purpose. I don't think my next few videos will have this. I guess that's it for this video. Bye.